Welcome to RMC Bishop Channel. According to Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 1379, the tabernacle was intended for the reservation of the Eucharist in a worthy place so that it could be brought to the sick and those absent outside of the Mass. As faith in the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist deepened, the Church became conscious of the meaning of silent adoration of the Lord present under the Eucharistic species. It is for this reason that the tabernacle should be located in an especially worthy place in the church, and it should be constructed in such a way that it emphasizes and manifests the truth of the real presence of Christ in the Blessed Sacrament. In the Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 2120, it speaks about the sacrilege, which is profaning or treating unworthily the sacraments and other liturgical actions. Sacrilege is a grave sin, especially when committed against the Eucharist, for in this sacrament, the true body of Christ is made substantially present for us. The continuation of this thought can be discovered in what Pope Francis said. Pope Francis noted, through prayer, a new incarnation of the Word takes place, and we are the tabernacles where the words of God want to be welcomed and preserved so that they may visit the world. What is the purpose of the Holy Scripture? Why do we read it daily? Pope Francis went on to say, the believer does not turn to the Holy Scriptures to support his or her own philosophical and moral view, but because he or she hopes for an encounter. The believer knows that they were written in the Holy Spirit. It is this encounter that makes the reading of the Scriptures lively and relevant. It becomes like a dialogue between the human soul and supreme soul, God. Here, incarnation of the Word in the human flesh of the reader of the Scripture can take place. It happens when one recognizes oneself in the passage or in a character or in a situation mentioned in the Bible. Pope Francis speaks of the importance of grace of God in this process. Pope said, it is a grace to be able to recognize oneself in the passage or in a character or in this or that situation. He made it clear at the same time that parroting of the biblical verses is not the end of the scripture reading. He went on to say that it was important to encounter the Lord with the heart and not just to recite a verse from memory. To conclude, in John 14:23, we read, Jesus answered and said to them, if anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and will make a home with him. Anyone who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them. We will come to them and we will make our abode with him. This is what Jesus is telling. And this is how we become tabernacles, or the reader of the scripture becomes a tabernacle, where Jesus lives in us through the means of reading of the Word of God and living it in our daily lives. Thus our families will be blessed. We will achieve progress in our lives in every day, in every way. Our houses will become temples of peace, love and joy. My dear brother, sister, if you want your house to be a place of peace, love and joy, then reading the Holy Bible every day and living according to the teachings given by God through it Let us not make the mistake of the rich man of the parable of Lazarus, who ended up in eternal hellfire. Every day, please devote some time for spiritual activities. Energize yourself by hearing spiritual talks. I propose to hear to everyone to hear two talks every day. In the long run, you will discover that the quality of your life and relationship with God and others has improved. Never give any publicity for all what you do in the spiritual realm. Do it quietly and grow surely and earn eternal reward. I will surely pray for you. May God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please look at the screen of your mobile now and see the word subscribe. If it is still in red color, please touch it now and make it black. Please listen to two talks daily. It will help you and you will be blessed. Once again, God bless you. Wish you a good day. Always your humble servant, Bishop Franco Mulakian.